Leave him. Leave us alone.
Hey. So, welcome to the I can't believe it's not the Taraco Artcast. And you can't spell Taraco without taco, baby.
Taco. Tacos.
Yeah, I think that works. Yeah.
And you can't have tacos without art, so it all makes sense.
Figured out. Boom.
I tried like hell to make a joke out of that. I just can't do it. Let me get my screen.
Put that in a fortune cookie.
I don't know if anybody got the notifications or what, but we're live on Facebook. We're live on StreamYard. Or no, wait, we're live on Facebook. We're live on Twitch, and we're live on the YouTube.
Yeah. Well, we got Occult Rights in the chat.
Occult Rights immediately says the election is a fraud.
Right, you know.
Why do you say that?
Straight in. Just go straight into it.
Who are you rooting for? They don't even know who won yet. How can you say it's a fraud?
All right. Because they didn't. So, I don't know.
And we don't know who won yet. So it's not. You better hold that fraud talk until you see who wins.
have to wait till the court case, apparently.
Oh, is that what it's going to come to in America?
Yeah.
Court cases?
It is.
Gosh, dang it.
Oh, I see it. I foresee that in the future.
Our freedom's being taken from us.
All right. You listen to my lips, good people.
Anyway, today we have a special guest.
Me.
Frank Salazar, who's been here before. Jebrin Redinger, who lives in my basement.
That's right.
And the Mask Woman, Anna Robb.
So special.
The newbie to the show, straight from the Amazon rainforest.
There it is.
That's it.
There it is.
That is one big plant.
You know, that sunlight. Go ahead. Sorry.
That plant has the same kind of leaves. My mom had a huge plant like that, and the thing was about, like, say, 7 feet tall in the living room.
Hello. This is well over 7 feet tall. I mean, it's got like nine leaves that are off camera right now.
Yeah.
Got like a bunch of really big ones. I don't know why I thought this was a good houseplant, but you know, it's an awesome houseplant.
Yeah, hers, it had the same kind of leaves, but it was more of like a single thing. It didn't kind of shoot off in different ones.
Mm-hmm.
And when I was a kid, I was running around with the dog through the house, and I crashed into that plant, and it fell over, and it broke, like snapped in half, like the whole front top part broke off. And I tried to like fix it very, you know, inconspicuously. And I thought, well, by the time it dies on the top, I could be back to my dad's house, because I think my mom and my dad were separated, so this was at her house. But of course, she freaking noticed like the second she got home, and I got all in trouble for that. So.
Oh boy!
It just grew back anyway. So, yeah, politics is already ruining the show. That's what Randy says. I agree, Randy.
That's right.
We need less politics and more Kill Reaver on the show.
That's right. More Kill Reaver live on the YouGoGo.
Yeah.
We need to start a radio show, man. Straight up.
Maybe we need like a Kill Reaver thing, kind of like a, you know, pro tip kind of thing.
I know. And you have like, It should do that every time. Kill Reaver, like Sunday at the Thunderdome.
Yeah.
Get one on week that, only, Randy. People.
Send us a bumper for our show, dude.
That's it, dude. Like really good, really good, real cheesy. Redneck is hail. Have you heard his? Go listen to his, dude. Like, he says it in the worst voice ever, if it's still up. Kill Reaver.
Oh, yeah? Is it on
I think it was at one point, man. That's the one, dude. That's the one. I mean, you got me so distracted what I'm doing over here.
I could play it. I guess we never have actually played the thing.
Don't you dare play his. Don't you dare report that on the channel. I'm just kidding. Do it, dude. Do it. All right. Just so y'all know, I'm on energy drink number 2.
That's a scary thought.
Yeah, it's a good
thing. You say energy drink.
Good thing. I'm exploding with it.
Let's listen to the Randy's video real
quick. Crank it up, Joe.
Right, oh, hang on. Mm-hmm. Let me crank it. God. There we go.
People get ready for to get blasted with some Kill Reaver.
Hey, I messed up. It's not on the video yet.
Kill Reaver.
That's so good. Right, put a little Megadeth in there.
Yeah.
Kill Reaver. I should sing to this. Come on.
Kill Reaver. Only on Indiegogo. Kill Reaver.
Perfect.
Nice.
That's intense. Oh, God. Stop.
Never go
back. Dear God. And I had my headphones.
Oh, my goodness. How did I just do that? Abort mission here.
That was pretty good. I guess the days of, like, you know, getting on camera and going, like, hey, you know, I'm Jeff Lafferty, and I need you to help me out with the comic kind of thing. Those are gone. Now it's just, like, a music video.
Yeah, it needs to be a commercial. Just something, you know.
Yeah.
With, like, a little bit of animation. Yeah. I wasn't watching his. Was it animated? He must have changed it, yeah.
No, it did do that. It did it right in the beginning. Didn't you hear it?
Yeah,
I could hear it. No, I heard it.
Yeah, it did it in the beginning.
It was funny. It was a bunch of metal. You know. Kill Reaver. Kill Reaver. Whoa, dude, slow down there.
Yeah.
Sorry. I'm just going to keep yelling Kill Reaver all night. Yeah. People, they'll spend money on Kill Reaver.
Yeah, he's at $400, so 39%. He's inching towards the thing. I'm waiting for it to take off like a bat out of hell, and
right.
I come here and he's like, you know, $8,000 or something. But I'm sure that's coming soon. Has he been on old Dan Fraga's show yet? I know that we're all holding out for that to be the big boom for him.
Yeah, before anybody spends any money, he's got to go on the Dan Fraga show. Is that how that works?
Well, maybe. Who knows?
I don't know.
He's been on.
I don't think he has, shows, though. Right? Fraga's supposed to do the cover, I think, though.
Well, yeah, that's why I keep saying, you know, Dan Fraga show, because I figure. Dan probably wants to get paid for that cover, maybe. So maybe it'll help him.
Yeah.
Invite him into the warm arms of Comicsgate.
Oh, man.
Will Comicsgate last the election, though? What will happen to Comicsgate if Trump gets beat, though?
Uh-oh. Is that in Comicsgate? Joe Biden's moving in, and he's going to join Comicsgate.
Oh, boy.
Oh, man. That would be interesting.
He's going to sell comics from his basement, too, like he can Mark Gobert.
Not like a rival
group. The basement
it's like the Super Democrats or something. They start their own kind of comics inclusion or something. Comics are for everybody.
Right. If you don't like that, we'll show up and burn down your downtown and smash out your window. No, I'm just
kidding. Yeah. I'm for
comics
it.
Open arms.
Oh, so Randy says he hasn't been streaming. Keith Harper says too much uncertainty in the stock market to invest in comics at the moment. Yeah, that's why I'm not investing in comics.
Yep, same here.
I got my eye on
the stock
market right now.
Well, I invested in this comic.
What's that? Oh, yeah. Davey Rocket. That guy gets more promotion. How about a few advertising dollars there?
Yeah, man, come on. Send them all right. You keep on a list, people. Don't understand that. You keep on a list.
Nothing's for free here, guys.
Nothing's for free, people.
Don't breathe that into my... That's right. Talk to my agent. Agent Orange.
Yeah, Josh Kimball's got himself an agent. He told me that when he was over there, when I was over on that ArtCast. He's got himself a literary agent.
Cool.
Okay. My question is this, Jeff. So I did we did a Taraku cast. I came on. You did the fake ArtCast. Where was I?
The fake. Oh. Yeah, I guess they didn't invite you.
Stiff army out the door like the Heisman Trophy.
Yeah, I think he said something like that, like in the back end when nobody was listening. He said, "Oh yeah, I thought about inviting Jib."
I'm just kidding. No.
I think Scott told him not to.
He thought about it.
Don't you get around? Don't come around. Just kidding. Talk.
They did check me at the door just in case I was going to sneak you in.
Yeah,
and then when they gave me the link, they said that link only is going to work once, so don't pass it to anybody. Wasn't planning on it.
Damn, why are being like this to me? Cold sweating me.
On this link. That was a fun show, though. I gotta admit.
I went back and watched it. We were talking about.
Did you? No, I'm just kidding. It wasn't a fun show. That was the most boring show I've been on all year.
There it is.
Right, Jim?
What's the best show you've been on?
See, I'm in contract to say whatever you say, Jeff.
ArtCast number 572 was the best one.
The best ArtCast was ArtCast 666. So good they took it down and banned it from the world.
Yeah. What took me down? I can't even remember now.
Midget boxing and rough and rowdy.
Which we
But here's the question is about. The next day. Did they take down the chant? Did they take down the what was it? LFL game, the booty football?
No, I didn't even get a strike on that. Is that crazy or what?
Booty football.
We were for like 5 minutes.
Wait, hold on. Don't forget it. You forgot it. We were on ArtCast and you sat there for like 20 minutes. No, I'm just kidding. Five minutes behind the scenes.
The rest of the show. But
exactly. He's like, I know who won that game.
But yeah.
That one girl had a really – one girl was a great tight end. I mean, wide receiver.
I think Scott was trying to avoid all the dungeon talk. That's what DJB says.
He didn't want me on the show. He didn't want to talk about – Six dungeon.
Pixel Traders here. Yo, dude.
Oh, hey, Pixel.
Yeah.
Yo.
I am back on my list, Pixel Trader, so your commission is coming very soon. I'm sorry it's taking me this long, but – I feel bad about that, but you know, I got to do them one at a time. Can't do them all at once.
Is that why you popped in to make sure you're doing it?
I don't know. He's probably just watching the show, but you know. Hi, everyone. Just thought I would stop in quickly. I'm really tired tonight. It looks like a good show tonight. Yeah, we're fresh off the Taraco cast. So we brought him over.
Two energy drinks and it's going to be good.
You guys go
check out the Truckle Creative Cast, and you can just watch the show that we were just on with Jeff.
Throw a link in the chat.
That is true.
Let me grab that one.
The moderator who would link it is in here, unfortunately.
Yeah, Keith don't link it. He'll link his own book. You're like, yeah. Talk computer. That's what I'm here
Why
to
did
do.
He, yeah. Why did he betray the pixels? He said that.
Oh.
What does that mean?
Pixel trader?
Oh, okay.
Oh, okay. Cracking the whip, stalking him on IGG and YouTube. Yeah. I know. I'm sorry, dude. I got a freaking list of people. So, but yeah, I'll probably do it like maybe this weekend. I don't know. That's the thing I just told somebody like 2 minutes ago. I'll do their piece next. So I can't really set up and do it next. It's just like, yeah. That's what you get when you take a month off, though, man. Stuff starts building up.
Well.
So what should we
build a haunted house in your backyard? Is that what you're saying, Jeff?
Yeah, I didn't do that.
You built a haunted house in your backyard. That's where you're at right now.
Jeff's a hobbit house. I thought you said a haunted house. Yeah, a hobbit house, definitely.
A hobbit house.
I wish I would have had a hill to shove it in. That would have been really cool.
Oh, that would be cool.
Yeah.
I think I'll do that.
Yeah?
You should have
an underground house?
Yep, that's kind of the goal.
That's cool.
You want to do like an earth ship?
Hmm?
Like an earth ship?
Yeah. I'm going to make it castle and hobbit hole and smash them together.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Yeah. That sounded horrible, by the way, but hey, you ride with that.
Well, did you have something there? You're waiting. I said, oh. Me? Yeah, I thought you were going
to
go
up. I don't know. What do you want from me now? It ain't happening. You're just drawing right now.
It says, name came from me trying to do more analog art. At the time, I was all pencil/ink/paper. Funny thing is, I wound up spending more time doing digital art anyway. Interesting, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, I see. So you're being like a trader to pixels. I get it. He was doing like traditional art. Is the masked woman using a tablet concerned, says. Whoops.
Often use a tablet, but I'm using the tablet right now, or it's an iPad Pro to do the live streams because I don't currently have a webcam set up, so I'm just sketching traditionally instead.
There you go.
Yeah. I'm using a tablet.
What, you're going digital on me, Frank? What the heck?
You better slow down.
The day.
How dare you?
So used.
You rue the day, Jeff. Dare you.
The biggest plus to the underground, you know what, actually, before I read that, is it isn't a bad thing to do like traditional on StreamYards, which is kind of like a flaw in their thing, even though I think StreamYards rocks, because I can't throw somebody's screen up. Like if somebody's sharing their screen, it always comes in like this, you know what I mean? So it's like their gigantic screen and then everybody else is midgetized. Uh-huh. So, you know what I mean? It's like if we were all doing digital art, we just can't have all of our streams having the digital art. I don't think, anyway. I'm pretty sure not, though. So Concern says what tablet, Frank?
This one.
Oh, this one. He doesn't know. You don't know it. He ain't telling you.
It's a Gaumon tablet. I'm not sure what size it is anymore.
It's a 420. Just kidding. So the biggest plus, see, they're not going to let me do any work. I'm just going to have to keep clicking any stupid things. The biggest plus to the underground house is all the bugs you can eat.
Uh-oh. Here we go. Straight into bug eating.
No.
Right to the bug eating.
You could just cut out like a big square out of the back of the refrigerator and then just come in there.
Maybe I didn't hear about the Jeff Lafferty challenge. The Jeff Lafferty challenge, you do for 1 million subs, he's going to eat a knot crawler. It's called the knot crawler challenge.
From X-Men?
And by he, I meant Frank. I got you, Jeff. Don't worry.
Yeah, so like that is true, as long as we're over here on my art cast where there's like people and stuff. I mean, that's not super cocky, but
we have people
that are subscribed to you guys. But anyway, go and subscribe to Anna Rob the Mask Woman and Frank Salazar. Or is it Frank also? It's you two, right? And then
Salazar Edition channel now too.
Yeah. And then once they hit how many subs? 100? 200?
100 subs for Anna.
Okay.
I already reached my goal, which was 200, so I'm a little bit over the goal.
Okay, so all you gotta do. Go Frank, go subs Frank too. We might as well get you guys both in there. Once they hit they're gonna make up some kind of bug cake or something and eat it live on the air. So
right.
I wanna
eat raw bugs.
We're gonna be eating some bugs. This. I'm not sure if there's gonna be cake.
Okay. I mean, okay, I personally would want them baked in a cake, but they're going for it like raw or something. And,
Well, another thing is, yes.
So go and sub those channels so that I can see this happen because, yeah, that's super weird.
If you get my channel to 1 million subs, Jeff will eat a nut crawler.
No, I won't.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, like actually, I'm never gonna have a million subs. But there we go.
Crawlers with the gummy worm dust stuff rolled around the dried and cooked earthworm. I've done
you that.
That.
What? Oh, so it was gummy worm dust?
It's, yeah, like that gummy worm stuff.
It's what?
And then you roll an earthworm in it and you cook it?
You couldn't, yeah, no. You ate it raw, right? You ate it raw though, right?
No, they cooked them.
Man, y'all don't eat raw bugs and worms?
Well, it's
those are the ones I want to see.
I guess you could probably make anything taste good, I guess. Maybe. Or sweet.
Once you roll it around and stuff. You cross your mouth and you just chomp it down. That's what I want. I'm like a locust. Like something fat and meaty where you know it's going to be gushy. Like a big old cicada.
Yeah, see that's what I don't dig. It's like I don't like the idea of like something wiggling in my mouth.
Yeah. Eat some raw grubs.
Yeah, I mean
delicious.
I've seen them like the dried out grasshoppers or deep fried or something like that.
Yeah, no.
I'd probably go for that, but you know. Mm-mm. I mean maybe like if I was on vacation in some place, you know, I had them. I would buy something to snack around the house.
I was lost in the mountains trying to find Jeff's Hobbit house.
Yeah.
You know, I'm like, I got to eat some grasshoppers and some grubs. Well, yeah, dude. Yeah. Everybody's going to be doing that.
Yeah.
You know, choking out mountain lions and drinking your own piss. Of course. But hold on.
For flavor.
Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Excuse me. Yeah, totally derailed the hell out of me too. Yeah. But dude, I don't know. But in normal life, no thank you. No thank you. Not eating the bugs.
So how did this become like the thing of like, I don't know. I mean, how did it even like?
Yeah.
The bug challenge.
How did it become a thing?
Yeah, how did it become a thing?
Let's see. Well, it goes back to an art cast of this episode where Anna kind of talked about in the chats.
Well, I get that. But it's like beyond just like that. I mean, how do you first come up with the idea to eat a bug? Which I know you said you eat them in the field, but I imagine you thought about that before. Like what puts it in your head in the very beginning that you're kind of like you're thinking about it, you know?
Yeah.
What, eat a bug in the first place?
Bugs, yeah, like I mean, what's the fascination with like bugs or something that brought on this I don't know, very weird.
Fearless child growing up, and a little bit.
Just not having this.
Okay.
Yeah.
There's some stories there.
Yeah, and I did it also a few years ago.
Some stories. Hold on. But you got some stories.
I know. I just implied that I.
Yeah, is that what you said?
Oh, she's got stories, but we're going to save them for the Taraco cast.
Oh, no.
I can tell you some.
Yeah, okay. She can tell you. I'll release her from her contract.
No.
You can tell one.
Kick him, Jeff. Kick him. I'm just kidding.
Well, yeah, I'd like to hear some stories, I guess. What do you got?
Let's see.
If I'm not putting you on the spot too much. C.B. Yeah. Smallwood pops up. The second you start talking about eating earthworms, C.B. Smallwood somehow shows up in the chat. I've always wondered what's up with that.
That's right.
Everybody needs to draw faster, like a Scooby-Doo running from a ghost skit faster.
Talking makes me draw slower.
Yeah.
No, he's always rushed.
The hair is so wild on this picture. I don't know what to do.
Get it done fast enough for that guy.
Yeah. I was that little kid on the playground who was like not really in any of the playground friend circles.
So just... back to these stories. Back to these stories. I ain't letting it go.
Yeah.
She's trying to.
We're going to hear bug eating stories. We lose everybody? Find out what's going on here.
That's what she's going with this.
Maybe he can't hear us. Can you hear us? Oh, there he went.
We lost him.
Yeah.
Y'all can act like I just told the most amazing story once he gets back.
Oh, that's a good idea. Yeah. I'm going to totally do that to him. Yeah. His internet connection probably crapped out. Here he is.
All right.
You guys ready? Oh my God, I cannot believe you did that. No, do not.
Wow, that was awesome, man. I've never heard that story before.
How's it going, Jib?
Hey, Jib.
Yep, kick me. Kick me.
I didn't kick you. Your internet is crap. What? Oh man, did you hear that story, Jib? You missed out on the
I missed the story. Damn it.
Oh,
Jeff kicked me.
No, I didn't.
Hey, what? I hear robots. Robots are attacking me.
CB says, don't use erasers. It will only slow you down. You drunk tonight, CB?
You kicked me, Jeff. Go. How dare you?
She's got that thing rubbed to the nub right there. What was the what were you gonna say though? No, seriously. I did want to hear that.
There it is. No,
so you started out, you were a child, you didn't have any friends.
So she ate a bug.
That's sadly more accurate than yeah, I petted bees and other weird things because why not? I was out there catching spiders.
Yeah.
Oh, he's gone now. Again.
Oh, oh wow. It'll straighten itself out.
You can watch the playback.
So you're petting bees and stuff?
Yeah. I actually occasionally would teach people how to do it, but I was just like a little kid. I only got stuck a few times.
Yeah.
But looking back, it does seem a little bit weird that I wasn't deterred by getting stung as like a preschooler. So
yeah,
and catching spiders because facing jumping spiders.
Oh yeah,
but still would go after them.
Yeah, bees. Like most little kids are really scared of bees. When I used to paint, though, yeah, it's like I don't know. I got so used to painting around them, you know, especially when you're always painting up somebody's bush or something like that. Then I don't know, you know, like they you know, go all around you, and they're not that aggressive really if you're not messing with them. Wasps are a little different, but
yeah, it depends on the species really.
Yeah, let's see, is Jib back? Where'd my mouse go? There it is. Hey Jib, can you hear us, Jib?
You back?
Might be. Keith Harper says, I'm out of liquor, or the liquor stores are closed. I have no choice.
Dun, dun, dun. Okay. No choice but
choice. Oh, what are they talking about? Oh, I'm sobering up. That's what Keith said.
Oh, okay.
Did I say Keith is drunk? I thought I meant CB was drunk. But...
Oh, and garter snakes.
Yeah.
You ate garter snakes?
Over the years.
I have like a thing about snakes, but I know they're fine. But, that would scare me though.
Yeah, I've always liked reptiles and amphibians and all of that.
Yeah.
Eating bugs and seeing them and playing with them just never really seemed weird to me growing up, even though I was called weird like every single day in school. So,
yeah.
Maybe some people thought it was weird. Just maybe.
Yeah.
Is that why you like hanging out with me, Anna? Because I'm a snake in the grass?
Snake in the grass.
Or you're weird.
I'm weird.
Well, Phoebe I'm says weird? Born this way.
I was born awesome. Or just weird.
You're born awesome.
I'm going with snake in the grass.
I was born a snake in the grass.
Yeah.
Actually.
So CB says, Gibran went. Yeah. Go ahead. I think we got a lag going.
The garter snakes around here, they don't even lay eggs. They're live bearers. So years of looking for garter snake eggs wasted.
Oh, okay.
Oh yeah, I think that is true because like I noticed that one time I saw this dead snake that was like ran over and it had a bunch of little babies in it, you know.
Little baby snake.
I think that's how they are around here too. No, seriously. Unless he ate them all, I don't know. They looked more like they were because they were tiny, almost like little.
Yeah.
Worms or something, you know. Not even worms, they were just little pencils.
Mm-hmm. That'd be babies then. They tend to eat a lot of slugs and ants and other obscure things. Not too many rodents, unless they're the larger garden species. There's several around here.
Snakes eat bugs, those weirdos.
So anyway,
if you see us eat bugs, subscribe to Anna and me and Keith, and we'll do that on a live stream.
We'll talk about entomophagy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Whoa.
That's the science of bug eating. So.
Yes, disclaimer, if you have a shellfish or, you know, like, I guess just shellfish mainly, allergy, they recommend that you avoid eating insects.
There you go.
If you're selfish, don't eat insects.
Well, I'm I'm definitely selfish.
The art cast also recommends that you don't eat insects, but
yeah, don't eat insects. Don't listen to these people.
We encourage it.
So CB said, or go ahead.
I got some crickets in the freezer. I can eat one.
You got crickets in the freezer, man. Hey, so do you go? You buy these crickets at the pet store?
You don't have crickets in the freezer?
Yeah, Gib.
Yeah, I would leave my crickets live and fresh.
Well, I caught a cricket and I stuck it in the freezer, but I did buy some on Amazon. Some of the flavored ones.
Amazon? You buying them imported crickets there from Amazon? Them Chinese crickets, man. Chinese crickets. You want to go to PetSmart so you know you're getting them from America. You want to look them right in the eyes, kill them yourself, and eat them fresh.
Yeah, well, I got one that I caught, and I was stuck in the freezer.
There you go. That's right.
Yeah,
torture that son of a bitch. Oh, that's all.
I forgot it's on my show. I couldn't tell Gib anything.
That's right. I can cuss all I want, you son of a bitch. Let's drop some F-bombs, yeah?
I had a suggestion
for the
creative cast, and I might as well say it now.
Yeah.
Whenever somebody wants to cuss, since we're trying to like keep it clean, just have like some makeshift word or do like Sims snortboard or something like that.
What? You're going to go into frats and frags?
Yeah.
Something weird.
Yeah, I think that might work. I try that with my son, but he still lets one out every now and then.
Maybe he'd be dropping them F-bombs.
Well, he likes to do it because it's funny, though. Like, he doesn't really care about it, but he thinks it's does it for the humor aspect. Mm-hmm. Well. So, CB says, I'm liking that drawing, Gibran, much better.
Oh, there you go. Hey.
And then he says, are you slowed down? I don't know. What's the speed thing? It's not about speed.
Yeah, he wants me to go faster. Yeah. He wants me to go
faster. You got to fill up 2 hours here.
Yeah, I know. That's why I slowed down.
Speed.
Yeah. I got a drink, man. See, I got to stop for a second and take sips.
Yeah.
Sipping my way through this live stream.
Also, what I'm
bourbon tonight. Yeah, there looks good. Typing on the old control pad there.
Yeah, moving on to the control pad.
Yeah, that one I gotta add text. And I gotta throw some graphics under.
Yeah. I don't like this one arm.
Oh, yeah, Keith says, says cuss you and then go cuss yourself. Like they did. You guys remember that in Fabulous Mr. Fox?
Mm.
That was their cuss words for cuss. Yeah. I just say cuss. I like that movie. I thought that was great. A little stop motion there. I like when the kid freaks out about like the bandit hats or whatever, because like the cousin gets to go on like the chicken stealing raid. And then they get shot at. And then the little kid's all mad because he didn't get to go. He's like, where's my bandit hat? This guy just gets here. He gets a bandit hat. Where's mine? Why did he get shot at?
Oh, that's...
So did you ever get any friends?
I've never seen Mr. Fox.
Oh, you should rent it. It's pretty good.
Very good question.
No?
Well, she has me. Yeah.
Yeah.
I talked to other humans.
Human.
Yeah, humans. What are these humans you speak of?
I'm pretty sure I'm not from Earth. I'm probably from the other side of the solar system.
Yeah.
Kick her now.
I was an alien.
That sounds good.
That works. I can say that now, Jeff, on the show.
Yeah. But we had that one show about aliens and all that. With what's his name?
Oh, yeah, that's right.
I can't remember who that was.
I was going to say. An alien show?
Well, remember the guy who was all into the conspiracies and stuff? He came on.
CB?
I remember this.
No, it wasn't CB, even though CB's into all the conspiracies too, but that was drawing a blank now. Which is probably bad because he's probably watching going like, oh, screw you.
Fuck you. Is he talking about me? He doesn't know any. He doesn't know either. Was it, no one knows what they say when they're on this show.
Was it the other Keith, Art or Die?
Art or Die. It might have been Art or Die.
Art or Die, that's right. Well, what's his real name though? I can't remember his real one. Of course, maybe we shouldn't say it. It's Keith something.
Farnham.
It's a. Farnham.
That's right.
Keith. All right.
Yeah.
So CB says.
Speaking of that, I'm going to throw this. I'm going to throw his throw stuff in the chat here. Oh, I got it. I hope I have it.
Yeah, CB had a book that failed its funding too. We should get together and force Gibran and CB to refund their books and get them out there.
Just force them to.
Yeah. Gibran will do it. All you have to do is just tell him to. Right, Jeff?
There you go.
I'm thinking about making Gibran eat the bugs too, but I don't know. That might be cruel.
Yeah, eat the bugs. All right. But don't forget, guys, you get me to 1 million subs, Jeff will eat a Nightcrawler.
No.
Yes.
Nightcrawler action figure from X-Men.
Yeah, no, like those slimy ass worms you can get from like
eat a
bait shop.
Actually, If you boil an earthworm after letting it
raw.
Sit or overnight, yeah, boil it raw, like in the microwave or whatever. It kind of smells famously between pork and chicken, and it has like this meat kind of texture.
Oh, Lord have mercy.
Nice. I want Jeff to eat it raw and slimy. I want it to wiggle in multiple parts while he chews it apart. Like he's like, now that I've chomped on it 12 times, I have 12 knot crawlers in my mouth wiggling around.
If you chop all right. And stick them in the freezer, just raw, they'll keep wiggling a little bit even after being in the freezer for several days.
Mm.
Oh, wow.
There's like some anti-freezing properties in their slime.
Oh, yeah. Wow. That's interesting. Yeah, that's probably, yeah, that makes sense. Because they probably got worms up there in Alaska and stuff. So
Jeff needs worms. Oh, give me 12 million subscribers. Jeff's eating a nightcrawler.
If you take the segment that has the, I don't remember what it's called, but it's essentially like the heart of the worm. It's the main circulatory system. And you let the worm continue to survive. "Quote unquote survive," it has like the head stuff. Apparently, it can also like regrow.
Oh, Lord,
but the other half of them dies.
Oh yeah, and they're delicious.
Oh okay, so that's like getting your arm cut off. Your arm dies, but then the rest of you survive, kind of.
Yeah.
But then it, Kate, you're talking about cutting off a major part of it though. Like, well, I don't know. Maybe you're not. I don't know. So you're talking about that big fat part. That's in it. That's got like the.
Yeah, that's
important. Yeah.
The band-aid part.
That's got the majority of the earthworm anatomy in it.
Oh, interesting.
Nice.
But it also depends on the species, I do believe.
Yeah.
We're talking. Dissected an earthworm in high school once.
Mm. Yeah, I skipped that class. I was like, I'm not freaking dissecting stuff. I don't know why. That just seems super weird to me. But I do remember that pigs in the jars and all that stuff. So CB said, my book didn't fail. It just said nobody bought it. Laugh out loud.
Didn't fail misery, CB.
And then he says, seriously, though, I'm still working on Wildcat in the Wildcat Anthology.
And there it is. A Wildcat Anthology. Are we still doing Sketching Past Midnight? I haven't seen them, man. I don't know if they're not showing up. My YouTube's been acting weird.
I caught one. Yeah, like about a week ago.
Yeah. Sketching Past Midnight with CB Smallwood.
CB says, what kind of breakfast are you eating? What do you have for breakfast, Anna? That's a good question.
Me?
Yeah,
we're going with you.
Well, I had a neighbor brought over some quail eggs because she raises quail, and then I whatever spice she mixed together that had a bunch of interesting peppers, and a salad mixed with that. I don't remember what else granola made
for breakfast. That's interesting.
Yep.
Yeah. What about you, Jib? What'd you have for breakfast?
I had coffee.
Coffee.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Coffee and have it hit the ground running.
I think I skipped breakfast today because I had to go to the grocery store, so I just ran out the door.
Yeah, there you go.
Usually I have like bacon and eggs. So.
Damn, those are big.
I had an apple.
An apple?
Yeah.
So Keith Harper says, wait, I'm confused. Is CB the same person as Art or Die?
No.
Yeah, we can combine those two into a conversation. They're different people.
Sorry. I'm looking, there it is. I was looking for CB Smallwood's YouTube channel, so we put it in there just now.
Stench? Whackbacker. Whackbacker.
Stench Whackbacker. What's up, man?
I think eating breakfast and listening to worm boiling has a bad time. Yeah. She even said it had a more texture. You are literally ruining ham for me. I just want you to know that.
Ruining what?
Ruining ham for me.
All those worms that I had were for a reason.
Mm.
You could go put a worm on a hook and catch a fish. That might taste a
little better. There you go. Bait, woman, you're eating the bait.
Mm-hmm. Eat the fish with the worm inside.
But you're like, all right, we got some bait. And turn out she's eating it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? You're like on a survival show with her. You're like, all right, I dug up these worms. Let me go try to catch some fish. You turn around, she's like, did you catch any more? I ate those. No!
Yeah.
And then she ends up surviving the show. And,
oh, I would, I bet.
And I'd be naked and afraid.
And then I'd be like, wait, can I actually just not move back into society and continue living out here?
Cool.
Can I continue to poop in the forest?
I do notice, though, on that like that Naked and Afraid show, though, that is the people who seem to do the best is the people who eat the worms and the bugs. And the people who won't do that pretty much starve out there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're actually, the bugs tend to be pretty good for you. Complete protein, complete amino acid, good fiber, roughage, I guess.
There you go.
It's good for you. Try it, Jeff.
What are y'all eating? Yeah. Join us. Whoa.
See, I like how CB just is completely ignoring the worm topic. SPM1. I wasn't able to use. So, SPM1, what's that?
Is that it's just past midnight.
Okay. I wasn't able to use Prisma Live Studio anymore. Due to YouTube restrictions, StreamYard became unstable after 20 to 30 minutes. I dropped and broke my phone. Interesting. Wonder why it gets unstable for you. Did you pay for like the whatever? The $20 one a month or whatever? That might be.
He was saying that earlier, maybe that it's his internet connection. His company like throttles him after so long.
Oh, I see. Especially where you're going through your phone. That might be true.
Well, tell them that you want to stream and play video games, dude, and they should set you up.
Yeah, he says, I'm going to try to make some high-quality videos soon for a while until I can get my YouTube issues and broken phone fixed. Mm. We could come on our show, CB, if you wanted to for a while till you get your shit together.
How dare you, Jeff? How dare you?
I'm just kidding. No, I mean, I'm not kidding about you.
Oh, I'm kidding. On.
I don't know.
You're not
kidding. I don't know if that helps.
That's a joke.
And again, how dare you?
Yeah, I don't know. Like, StreamYard seems to. I really like StreamYard. I've really always had trouble streaming. Like, even back when it was like just a YouTube. Google Hangouts or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
It seemed like when we get a lot of people on, man, it would just kind of grind to a halt. But StreamYard is like, you know, rocking, man.
I got it down a little better.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like
and now correct.
Yeah. What are you saying, Frank?
Oh, you remembered I was here?
Yeah.
I was saying I like StreamYard. I like using StreamYard.
Yeah.
Joking.
Yeah. Someone was recommending Streamlabs, but on OBS. I think it was actually Anna's cousin was suggesting it to
us. Oh, yeah.
Jonathan.
Yeah. Is that the Candyman?
No, that's the business guy we had 2 weeks later.
Oh, right.
Behind.
But he introduced us to the Candyman.
Ah.
Okay. I swear. Yes, the Streamlabs, though, is... Because I remember checking that one, too. And, it was because, the OBS thing. Which I do have OBS, but I always had so much trouble with it when I tried to stream to Twitch that I got so sick of it, you know. But I use it when I screen capture stuff for videos. What's was that dance we were running over?
That was me getting excited by sketching and wanting to draw a background all of a sudden, but trying to I wanted to draw a background.
She was stoked about OBS, bro. She was like lit up.
I glanced out when I caught the very end of that.
People. Me, myself.
I didn't see it.
Prisma Studio Live is awesome for a one-man show, but StreamYard is great for the, for having guests. Prisma Studio Live, I don't even know what that is, I guess.
It's a streaming thing, but for one person only.
Oh, is it?
That's what a CB was telling us once.
Oh, was he? Okay. Has CB been on the TeracoCast also?
Yeah. Not on the TeracoCast, but he was on just a random stream that I did, and I invited people on from the chats, and he was there. I had him on, and Anna was on, so we had
I like Anna way better. See you later, CB.
Sorry, kicked out CB.
Oh, there it is.
That's pretty much. He's here now. CB's got one.
Yeah, he's gone. Later, CB. Don't worry, when he kicks me off, we'll start a show.
That's why Keith and CB are hanging out in the chat right now. Yeah. Working hell, sideburns. There's all kinds of people in here I haven't seen before. It says, good day, hey. I'm work. Working hell. Damn your work. Damn it.
Yeah. Screw that shit, dude. Quit now.
Yeah.
Today's the day. Today is the day. You just. Sorry.
No, I don't think anybody should do that, actually.
Cyburns is in the second anthology for the manga.
Oh, is he?
Yeah.
Cool. Well, I guess I'm going to have to get over there and pick that dang thing up.
Hey, hope I got it in here.
You bought it?
Oh, I mean, I have the link. I'm looking for the link, Joe.
Right. Oh, okay.
Peddling, dude. I'm pushing. I got my QVC going.
Yeah.
I'll be hating on my QVC, dude. Let's see here. It's 9-volt, too, right?
The pulp. Yeah, which I was able to get two stories in there, two little short stories.
That's cool.
Yeah, they're deeply introspective and meaningful, and they'll definitely, especially that second one.
Yeah.
Really poured his heart into it.
That's cool.
And making fun of me.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Although the Great Canuck one almost had a heart attack over that one. I gave myself an anxiety attack.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because I lost a page. My tablet glitched. An Android tablet that I have. Everything I had saved, it was lost, but I was able to save some earlier drafts of it before. So I just kind of hodgepodge some of it together.
My favorite word. You did end up losing it then? Yeah, I mean.
Yeah.
Oh, man. What a drag.
Yeah, I had to kind of like redraw some panels and reuse some art and some other stuff. But yeah, I lost like, I think I spent like a couple of days on that page and I lost it all in minutes, seconds.
Oh. Yeah.
Well, if you use CB's philosophy of drawing faster, you would have only lost minutes worth of work. Think about it.
Yeah. I'm not good at drawing fast. I mean, I have my moments, but yeah, it always seems like when I need to, it's like, out there. Thank you. I feel your pain, Frank. Technology always fails me. Traditional is the way. Oh, I like that. Traditional is the way. I'm going to start saying that like that dude in Dune.
The way.
Yeah, the way. Traditional is the way. Something is a fear killer. Everybody says that movie. You guys remember?
Mm-hmm. I don't want to
win. Yeah. That you know, dude that drinks the stuff all the time and says that little prayer after each one. Okay. Something's a fear killer. Oh, maybe he says the spice is a fear killer.
It's not the Fat Boy, is it? That's the only one I really remember.
Baron Harkonnen with all the gross pus things on him.
Hell yeah. The Baron.
Oh yeah, technology is the mind killer. So see if you put it in there. I love it. I like his bear with the sunglasses too. That's pretty good.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Oh,
yeah, fear. I really like the little bear.
That's what Keith, he's on. Fear is the mind killer. That's what he's saying.
Don't you be correcting people, Keith. Fear. Keith, kick yourself.
The mind is the mind killer. That's what Stinch Whackbacker is saying. Okay. I don't think that was it.
Drugs are a mind killer.
That was pretty good. There's like a... Are they redoing it now on a channel or...
Yeah, I think so. I think something's getting redone.
I kind of want to see it. I remember they did a Dune on like the Sci-Fi channel like mm-hmm. back in... early 2000s, which wasn't bad.
All right.
It was like, okay, yeah. But I'd like to see them kind of redo a new one, though. All the new special effects and stuff they got going.
See those damn worms?
Right.
Damn worms.
Well, I mean, the movie was just, you know, it was like, how much of that book can you really shove in a movie, you know? So it's kind of like left out a lot of stuff. That's what I liked about the sci-fi series. But I'd like to see him make a really cool one, kind of like almost like a Game of Thrones version of the books with like everything in it. That'd be really neat.
Hmm. I say no. Let Dune die.
Just get it out of here.
Fucking put Sting in it one more time.
Do what?
Put Sting. Oh, wouldn't Sting.
In the first right. Movie. Yeah. Well, you said Sting. I thought you were talking about Sting in the new Doom or something.
I want Sting in the new Doom. Can't do that. Then get out of here.
Yeah, Sting's like an old man now.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding. I don't care. I don't really care. I look good though.
I really like that movie though. That early one. I don't know. But they did pretty good for what they had.
I wish they would make a good H.P. Lovecraft movie.
That would be interesting. But you know, it's like I feel like they're hard to do. You know, a lot of like what makes those stories so creepy is like the monsters and stuff, like your imagination of what they are, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, keeping them in the background and not really kind of revealing and letting your mind play on that stuff. Yeah, no, I get you.
Yeah, I feel like if you put that in front of you and you're just making a big monster, it's not as scary as its description.
Have you ever seen Dagon? Because Dagon is good.
Uh-uh.
Hey, well, you gotta watch Dagon. Yeah, it's a movie. I think it came out in like the late 80s, early 90s. Really good. It's like one of my favorites. One of my favorites. But yeah, you should go check that one out. It's
really good. So Keith says, I remember seeing the David Lynch version of Dune back in the 80s. First movie I had been to where they gave you a handout of the backstory and major characters to understand the movie. Oh, that's super weird.
Whoa.
So they had to explain the movie to you?
Well, maybe, because I'm sure I saw that on video. I don't think I saw that in the theaters. So maybe, like, you know, since it was connected to such a big book, you know. Any artists you gals and guys are inspired by lately? I have a list ready in case anyone asks.
Anna Robb.
Woo!
Yeah, I'm inspired.
What were you inspired by?
Who, me?
No, she said she started to say who she was inspired by, but then she stopped.
For herself.
Anna Robb.
Wow, me. There you
go. I would say all of you random people and my art teacher. Oh, I had a list. I used to have a list.
Okay.
All right, here we go. I got one. Jeff has made me want to stop drawing. Boom.
It's great.
He has made me.
I think we did a show right on it on our influences.
We did.
Oh yeah, Gabe was under.
Yeah. I think I changed up my influences even for that one. Drawing some new ones that I like. But no, yeah, I don't know. It's like lately, dude. It really. I'm just okay. How about this? I've really been enjoying those Frazetta Girl Instagram posts that we always bring up. Those things, they still every time, man. Every time they put that close up in there, it's just like, wow. And you can really look at it. And I really like that.
Yeah.
And you know, and it's all the same guy as always. When you see something new, though, it's kind of cool.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of seeing Simon Bisley do those, like, he's done some like really quick sketches recently and some stuff, kind of real fun, quick. And I really like those too.
Yeah, I've been checking those out too, and those are awesome. Do you follow Bisley on there, or just like hashtag Bisley?
I follow him.
Yeah. I'm gonna try to find that Sarah Frazetta's feed because I think those are so cool.
Just the same guys, you know. But I guess really lately, the guys I've really been just kind of staring at, you know, always Biz, but man, that and Corbin, dude. It's always them, always looking at Corbin's work. Guy, something he did, man. Those colors and his, like, really, you know, I don't know. Some things he's done, like, he was really good at, like, taking a cartoony shape and making it look kind of realistic.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I agree. He's got such a, I mean, it's inspired, but it's also so unique, you know, to himself. You know, you can see it in other things. So, like, here's actually, I wanted to show everybody. This is like her page, Sarah Frazetta's page on Instagram. Everybody should go follow this if you're into Frazetta because this is amazing. And like what she'll do is she'll post, like this is all of her pictures together, but then she'll post stuff like this. So you get like a super close up and a lot of times even closer than these. Mm-hmm. And then later on, you know, and it's like you can get in there and just like see those paintings like you never could see them before. See, like there's another, there's a bottom half of that horse. And they are just... Cool. Really interesting in like from my perspective of just like never really getting a chance to see those paintings up close. And then also if you're kind of just, you know, like I'm a student of the guy's technique and it's just neat to be able to see like the brush strokes on those things and stuff. So, but yeah, that definitely inspires me too.
Very well done.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, he's definitely a master.
Yeah, as far as I go, like I don't know that there's like anybody super new. I mean, I really got into like looking at those guys who were doing the Conan books, the new Conan books. And the one guy's got like a name I can never freaking remember. like DDR or something. It's like a European guy. That's kind of the last guys I was really looking at as far as like inspiration, I would say. I mean, I see a lot of good art that I just like to look at, but like those are kind of go like, oh, you know, I need to up my game kind of thing, you know? Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Let's see here. How do I get to those things?
So let's see. Kisa, or no, wait. Jungin. Uh-oh. They're going on and on. Well, they're talking about Lovecraft. I was trying to find what CB said, like his favorite artists or his inspirational artists were. Oh, Keith said it was a pamphlet that the ushers gave you. I wish I still had it. That's interesting.
Very cool. Hey, I think I sent you this the other day, Jeff, and I wanted to share it on the show. But an artist name, I think it's Ender. I think you say it as Ender 17. He's an Instagram artist. He does these cards. He did a Doomed Barbarian and a Berserkernaut card. Did
you see that? Yeah.
Oh, wow. Yeah, I wanted to show those off. I have them pulled up, so I'm going to share my screen. And if you want to share my screen, we can go that way.
Let me take that guy's comment down real quick.
Let me tell you when here. Go for it. Can y'all see that? The Doomed Barbarian one.
That looks so cool.
Did a really good job, man. Came out badass. And here's the man himself, Berserkernaut. Very cool.
That is really cool.
Yeah. And that is, I want to say you say it, Ender 17, because I think it's Roman numeral 17 there. I'm going to put his Instagram in the chat.
Yeah.
But there we go. Cool.
Go check out him. There's very so cool, much good stuff. Cool. Yeah, on Instagram though. You know, I honestly love going through Instagram. I've also follow like just Jack Kirby art, and they just post like random Jack Kirby stuff, you know, that you just don't see that much. Too, and it's just really neat to, you know, just you wake up in the morning, there's some Jack Kirby sketches you never saw, you know what I mean? It's really fun, you know. I think Instagram is probably like my favorite. It's like my favorite social media, honestly, Instagram. Because it's just, there's no, you know, when I come here, I don't have to like, you know, there's no big political rants. I don't have to run into somebody's, you know, innuendo type stuff. Nobody's ever mad on here. It's just art, you know?
Yeah.
So
you can set it up to be that way for sure.
Yeah. Whereas like, you know, I take one step in Facebook and I slip on the oil slick, of, you know, I'm going to start naming people, but you know what I'm saying? And then it's just like, you know, you trip over, you know, this other guy's post and this, you know, this other thing falls on your head like a, Viet Cong. I don't know. Anyway, it's just a big drag over there.
Yeah. Hey, where's that? In Facebook.
Facebook. Yeah.
Hello, Facebook.
Yeah, his name's Ender Vix.
That's Vix.
XVI. Oh, it's probably Ender XVI. Actually.
Right? Yeah, XVII. I would forget to be Ender 17, maybe.
Yeah.
The X being the 10, the V being the 5, and then 2 1s.
You're hitting me with that big knowledge, man. Good job. Man,
hold on. It'll go in a second. Oh, let me take another sip. Let's see if we can get rid of that. Kill some right tail. All right. Back to drawing this weird looking dude with swords. But you know what we should do? Since we love clicking, maybe we should click on over to the ArtCast Facebook group and see what's going down. See if people have been posting there, because y'all should be. We should be backed up with posts.
Since we're Slack. We could do that. So anyway, CB says he's really digging Brett Booth right now. I really like how he draws hair and details. I like Kiyu Young Oum Eom for his well-rendered ladies, Neil Adams for stellar storytelling and faces, and Rob Liefeld.
Oh, we knew that one was coming in.
It's Rob Liefeld.
Because he's fucking Rob Liefeld. He's the only man that can draw a person's chest, open it up like a refrigerator, and get it published.
Yeah, Neil Adams definitely was. He did some great comic book art back in the day, for sure.
Yeah, Neil Adams was badass, dude. That, hey, is that who did the no, that's Tom. Is that what I'm thinking of? Who did that beautiful Frankenstein poster you could buy in Creepy? Was that Neil Adams?
No, that was Jack Davis.
Jack Davis, yeah. Oh, I love that thing, dude. That was so good. Love that freaking Frankenstein. How dare he draw something so beautiful?
Yeah, I should go. I'll haul it over to the Facebook. And maybe I'll try to find out on the way.
That is, dude. That's definitely one of those images, dude. That when I see it, I'm just like, that man had talent.
I wish I'd have bought that thing back then.
Yeah, me too. I wish I had it now, dude. I'd hang that thing now.
I wonder if we can't actually find them anymore on eBay or something.
You just buy an old and like redone Vampirellas and just order it, right?
Yeah. Send your $7 in, see if you get it. Here it is on eBay.
$125. Oh.
That is really neat.
I need that one. I need the one where Eddie's kicking in the door, driving through it with the motorcycle or whatever he's doing. But that thing is, yeah, oh my God, that thing was amazing.
Yeah, beautiful. Jack Davis was awesome artist. Very cool. Actually, they've got a few of them on eBay. Now I'm going to get sidetracked. 14 inches by 36 inches. Or no, 14 by 36? That's not right. This thing is supposed to be like...
It's supposed to fit on a door.
Like 6 feet tall, man. Come on. Yeah,
supposed to be door size. People printing them at the wrong size.
I wonder if they are.
Man, you know that's what's going on, man. You know how much stuff I've ordered like that before, and it's been like, oh, man, this ain't right.
Bootlegging it?
Yeah. Got the old bootleg going.
Oh, this is really cool, Jim. Let me check. Show this.
What are you talking about, man? The one.
Cartoon.
Somebody's got it, yeah. That's dope.
That's a great picture.
Oh, wow.
I don't know how to do that. I can't read the name.
That's what's up, dude. That's what's up.
Anyway. So the art casters. Let's hit it. Posted anything on art casters lately, Frank?
I think last time I was on the stream, I posted the pages I was working on.
Oh, cool.
I posted the link to the show, the Toracle Cast.
There it is. That's good enough for me. I'll take that one.
So we got some Keith Harper backstory. It may or may not be canon. So it looks like he's throwing some notes down, some sketches. That's pretty cool.
Oh, yeah. Very cool.
I like how that looks.
Work it out.
Nice. Elizabeth. This is Lisa Eldred. She's on Twitch, I guess. Streaming it up.
Oh, yeah.
Making stuff, looks like. Costumes and stuff, I suppose. Peter Palmiotti. I love a gal who reads. That's Pete. Oh. This is a work in progress. We'll go to inks. There you go.
Unlike me, I love a girl that breathes. Oh, sorry.
A little, okay. There's the LR cast. Or no, that's the Taraco cast. What am I saying? Yeah. Mixed up or
Morocco cast. That's a creative cast, right? It's a creative cast. Yeah. They only have creative people on, even though they let me on. Thank you guys.
Yep.
Constantinos Pachelios doing his webcomic Silk and Metal. He's always working on that thing. Got old Wall's Destiny. Oh. Nice drawing. Girl with a tattoo.
Back off that a little bit. That's looking great.
Yeah, that looks nice.
Showing a little of that side, baby. Oh, Kill Reaver live on Kill Reaver.
Says he was on right now. WYZ Entertainment's YouTube show earlier talking about Kill Reaver.
Better, man. You better be selling that thing like it's a new prescription drug to get rid of, you know, that thing. The Seaver.
The Wise Guys Entertainment show, I guess. That's cool. Pete going live. Vicious, oppression, tedious, evil. I guess you guys got to watch to find out what that means. Independent comic creator, currently crowdfunding, David Fleming, Randy Siplon, Russ Leach, and Ryan Wynn. I'll have links in the link trees. That's cool. Yeah, I think we looked at it. Yeah, we looked at that Ryan Wynn the other day, I thought. And a lot of shows. 48-hour art check, around 600 or 263. Oh, wow. Scott and them, arting it up. Elizabeth on Twitch.
I mean, what are people really doing right now, lazy bastards?
Original art show and tell with Glenn Danzig. What's this, Keith Harper?
Yeah.
It's real. It's real, though.
So what is it? Glenn Danzig going to his comic book collection?
He's showing a little bit of his art. Yeah, he's got some, shows a couple of pieces. He's got some really cool stuff.
Oh, wow. That's pretty cool.
He shows two Vampirella Frank drawings he has.
Neat.
Off Jeff Go.
Vampirella Frank Frazetta did them? Mm-hmm. Oh, wow. I'll have to watch that later. Check him out.
Oh, yeah. You'll notice that my voice is spot on.
Is it?
No. Really?
So somebody on TikTok, Brian Rempel.
Oh, yeah.
Crayon Zombie Drawing. More Kill Reaver. Nathan cool. West. Oh, cool. It's like he colored up something. Neat. Yeah.
Very cool.
Almost finished cover for the first issue of my comic. I wasn't happy with the first one for the first issue. That was, yeah, I remember that other one. You remember that other one?
Mm-hmm.
That you drew with this chick here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I love that outfit, by the way.
Well, I thought she was topless in the other one, I guess. I didn't realize it was like super form fitting or something. I like both. Yeah, that's good.
He took the boob window in a whole different direction. Yeah.
Yeah, really. Maybe let's see. That's great though. He's putting a comic out. This is awesome.
Very awesome.
If you I don't know if Nate's listening today. I imagine he'll come by later. But if he crowdfunds or just puts it up, you know, definitely come on the show and promote it, man.
Come on anyway. Come hang out.
Yeah. Peter Palmiotti, a piece I inked over Joe Martino's pencil, originally for Dave Cochran's Get Well card. It wound up in a tribute book. That's pretty cool. And Constantinos. A lot of art shows, but not so much art. Let's see. Wall's Destiny, that looks good. God, we haven't been here for a while. Well, Creed Stonegate.
Uh-oh, evil Santa.
Looks like you put up a video. Time for some Christmas spirit.
Oh, boy. Already there. Man's as fast as Walmart with that Christmas jangle.
I got to swing by and grab some stickers off of Creed's site there.
I feel like I should do that too. Subscribe. I'd love to
says Honor Rob is 34 subscribers, shy of reaching your goal of 100 subs.
Make this woman eat bugs, people. Come on. If she ain't subscribed long enough for her to eat bugs.
He's definitely like, yeah, that's, I don't know what to think about that. Everyone's helping me that hard to eat like a plate of.
I don't know. This is how much I want to see her eat bugs. I'm subscribing right now. Bam. Oh. There we go. All
right.
One subscriber closer to bugs.
Oh, I see it. I got the notification.
You weren't subscribed earlier?
Huh?
I'm going to start judging you for not subscribing earlier.
Yeah.
What do you mean, Jim wasn't subscribed? Are you kidding me? What the hell?
Oh, dude.
God.
I don't know what's going on. What do you want from me? What do you want from me?
I don't know. I'm subscribed, Nora. I think I subscribed. I'm pretty sure I did.
Jeff, you're not even subscribed to my channel. What are you talking about?
I know I'm subscribed to yours.
Jeff, you subscribed long enough to just, you said you subscribed long enough to cancel.
I subscribed long enough to get your free thing, and then I got off the list.
Good, good.
Like I did with Scott.
There you go. Give me the Comic Maker Pro or whatever that is.
I sign up to Scott's mailing list like daily. I just like go and get a burner account, and then I subscribe, and then I jump back off just to drive him crazy.
Yeah, just take that stuff for free.
He gives away a lot of free good stuff. Yeah.
He does.
No, I'm kidding. Don't do that.
He does.
Scott hates that. That's like getting a free car wash and not paying the poor homeless kids that are doing it. So
not tipping them. It's like it's free. It says donations, and I'm not willing to give.
Well, that's like a bait and switch, though. You put them to a free car wash, and then then it's not free. What the hell, man?
Donations. We're taking donations. It's like, don't sucker me in with your sob story. Get out of the way, sucker.
That's what I say. I'd be like, good luck with that. See you around.
Yeah. We push your way through. So I'm in the car. You're an idiot.
I'm kidding.
What?
Yeah, that happened to me before.
I don't wash my car, so that's what the fucking
rain is. Yeah, me neither. Well, for you. It's for all those suckers that do.
I do think that though. Like, why? Who spends freaking $5 to go wash your car? Are you kidding me? It's not gonna do that.
All right, that's for suckers.
I'm just
I could drink that water.
I'm offending. Let's go. My subscriber base. I just got a car wash today. What the hell does Jeff mean by
that? Yeah. Oh, what did car washes for?
I thought I liked you, Jeff.
How dare you? You know what? Dude, I was gonna buy a print, and I had it in the checkout and everything, but I'm deleting it.
They were right there at the checkout, and then
By the way, you can pick up some of Jeff's prints right now. Where do you have those prints right now? On eBay, or do you have them on Facebook?
They are on Facebook, but I don't know how you find them there. So.
So go straight to that eBay.
Etsy.
All right.
Yeah.
Exactly. You can find Jeff's eBay right here, though.
I got the link. Chat.
Oh, you know it.
Yeah. And they're free shipping also inside the U.S., so that's kind of been driving up.
So,
quite a few, yeah.
So what's holding you back from buying one? That's what I want to know.
And if you're out of the country, I might as well mention this because this has been something that's coming up. I combine shipping, too, so...
Oh.
You know, if you buy a few, you only should pay for one print to ship. So
there you go. That's awesome, people.
Yeah, and I am still selling on Facebook. It's funny, I had a guy come over today, or is it today, or was it yesterday? I think it was yesterday, actually. And he bought one. It's weird they're selling, like, here, you know? I mean, it's like... I never thought that would work in a million years, and I've sold, you know, probably 8 so far, and I've only been doing it for a couple weeks now.
I was just like to say, hey, I'm going to hang out, bro. What's up? What are we eating for lunch, dude?
Yeah, I know. That's my fear.
meeting those motherfuckers. I'll meet you at 7-Eleven, bro.
Well, yeah, that's what I try to do with most of them. But then you have like the repeat guys now, where they're coming back, and then they're more like, well.
That's the one, though. Here's what's up, dude. You're like, well, that guy's the guy I'll be nice to. No, man, you got to be careful. That's the one you need to worry about, Jack.
Yeah, you might be right.
That's the one you need to worry about. That's the one that's going to show up and be like, what do you mean, Jeff? I can't hang out? But I carved a picture of a bit of a record out into my chest.
Yeah.
With a butcher knife. I'm getting a butcher knife right now. I'll be over, Jeff, in about 10 minutes.
This is why Jevon tells me this shit, because it's like, you know, he knows what he talks about. Got on like a freaking Skype call with him for like 10 minutes, and it's like, now he never leaves.
Right. You don't want that. You can't get rid of me. That's right. I just pushed my way back in.
And that's how we ended up here. We went from my stream to this one.
Yeah,
that's right.
Yeah. No one was invited. We forced our way in. This is a home invasion.
If we were all like living in the same spot, I'd want to go to Anna's house. I could hang out in her her garden there.
There you go.
There it is. What?
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Well, I'm confused.
Did you see that? Look at the screen.
No, I didn't. I got one of these too. Where's mine?
Oh, man.
Oh, I have one somewhere. I don't know where it's
going. Is like live in the swimming pool, the concrete.
Yeah. Mine must have walked off.
Oh, I just got this.
All right. When you pull those out, you know what you got to say when you see those? You say, so I take it you've been to Florida. Yeah. The only place I've ever seen those is just like in a convenience store chilling. Like, hey, you want to buy a gator head? We got them.
Yes.
I might buy one of those if I saw them. I guess that must be like the rattlesnakes when you get down south. They have all like the gas stations, the rattlesnake keychains and shit.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. You know, how that shit. They got to get their gimmicks in.
Yeah.
The rattlesnakes, it's like, these are killing people, but hey, would you like to have a dead one? Well, I guess on both aspects, even the gators that way.
Yeah.
You know, gators are like cougars where you're at.
Yeah.
They'll kill the joggers. Joggers no more. They hate joggers, dude. I don't know what's with the wildlife and joggers. They hate them.
Yeah.
Don't jog, people. Wildlife will kill you.
Well, I mean, I can see why. I mean, just think of like a mouse jogging by a cat. You know what I mean? Of course he's going to go after that. Yeah. You know?
Yeah.
At least
the wildest thing I can. I know he's like, oh, that shit's colorblind, but I don't know.
Yeah. What's colorblind? What do you mean?
Are animals colorblind? I don't fucking know. I know they're stupider than me. I'm smarter than they are, Jeff.
I don't know.
I've got intelligence.
Yeah.
Dogs are colorblind, but I don't know about other animals.
So, Stench Whacker says, Whackbacker. I can't say it. I'm sorry. Jeff Lafferty, this is an example of stream rating. Are they raiding my stream, or did I raid their stream and drag them over?
Where?
All of the above. Let's just all of the other streams.
And CB, how does car? Oh no, Stinchwalk Ockbacker says, how does car washing improve muscle memory when drawing?
Oh,
CB, here we go. See, I love to read them backwards because they make no sense. And I just make everybody feel like an idiot until I finally.
Then we can just speculate what we want about what they said.
I spend $1 on washing my car, but running around the car, speed washing, taking a washer, I quickly scrubbing, and then spraying off before the timer kicks off. Great training for faster drawing.
Yeah, so that's what he's saying. He's saying not only does he draw fast, but he walks the car fast.
Yeah. He's talking about going to one of those ones that where they got the hose and little put the quarter in, and you got like, you know,
you run around,
wash your car, so hurry up. Yeah,
learn karate.
We used to have a lot of those around here, but now they're all kind of like the big fancy, like where there's like 7 bays of like car washers, and, you know, it's like, what the hell? When I look at that, I think the world is coming to an end. You think that's what they're going to have, an end time car washing place like that?
It's good.
Well, they're already.
What? Were there already? You mean the car washing places or the end of the world?
End times. End times.
The end times are here.
End times. Yeah. I'd say roll credits.
You'd say that, Frank.
Roll credits, people. We're done.
It's over.
Throw in the towel.
Well, if Trump gets voted out, he's not actually the Antichrist. So then I don't know. Maybe we're not at the end times. No, stop. I was saving that joke for my mom because I can't wait to hit her with that, but I don't know if he's going to get voted out. So.
No. Well, look at the time.
Oh, man. It's killing me, though, to be honest with you. What the hell's going on?
Yeah.
Stretch my back.
So I've been contemplating the fractals of the universe.
Oh yeah. That's a conversation killer right there.
Yeah, maybe a band.
No, you're
Roger.
Now.
What are the I mean, was that serious? Like what the heck is that? I don't even know.
What?
Fractals?
Yeah, like the Fibonacci.
Those little poops.
And other
little graphicals,
mathematical things that are involved in stuff.
Oh, yeah, I see what you're saying.
The art of math, or the math of art.
Yeah.
Vice versa.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think, I mean, it is interesting how all that works out, like the golden mean or whatever, you know, like Da Vinci's
the golden ratio.
Yeah, and then
the golden ratio.
The way flowers grow, or like, you know, and they'll do that same thing.
That natural pattern, the shell.
Yeah, the seashells, same thing.
Yeah, that's the Fibonacci sequence.
Right, yeah.
Just so.
And then there's the Pinsley fern, which is the fractal for fern growth.
Oh, yeah.
Those are all a bunch of lies.
Even knew what the hell
they were.
So it's like the way a friend grows, like a little bit, like the way it shapes out, you mean?
I've seen that movie where it grows, that poor dog.
Where the red friend grows.
That poor dog. They don't make me sad, people talking about ferns. I'm sorry. Red friend grows.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah. All right. Well, what's your
favorite
sad movie?
Yeah, what was that guy? Is it the Red Friend? What's that show? The Red. Oh, I think it's a Canadian show. The guy was Red something. It wasn't Red Firm, was it? The Red something show. We talk about it every once in a while.
Grows.
Where the red fern grows?
Yeah, it is a movie.
The dog gets killed, but what's that show I'm thinking of? A comedy show. I thought it was the Red something show. Red Fox? No.
Oh, Red Green.
Red Green show.
Green.
Yeah. Red
greens. That's funny. I gotta cheer myself up after y'all bring it, making me think of the red fern. No, bastards.
Yeah, that is a funny show. I dig that.
But the red fern? How dare you? I knew you hated dogs, Jeff.
Old Yeller was hilarious.
How dare you? How dare you?
Come on.
I laughed and laughed.
That's it. Yeah, that's what you do. You sit down with your kid, you're like, oh, you want a dog, huh? Well, we got to watch a movie first. Come here. We got a couple movies we got to sit through. I'll get you a dog if you don't cry.
Old Yeller, Red Fern Girls, Turner and Hooch.
Turner and Hooch.
Turner and Hooch. Yeah, we got to send him to that one. Of course.
And K-9. Although he lives,
and Turner and Hooch, the dog doesn't die, does he?
Yeah, it dies in the towards the end.
They have a
puppy.
Yeah, that's it. You got it, and then you end it. You end it with Cujo. Bam. Kid survives that. He gets a dog. Yeah, there it is. CB says it to Cujo. She's on the same level. Cujo. We're there.
Yeah.
That's right. Cujo. Man's best friend. One bite at a time.
That was a good one.
Yeah.
Right. I like that. Did you guys see that one with Harrison Ford like recently here? The remake of White Fang.
Oh yeah, I never saw it, but I heard of it. Was it good?
It was pretty good. Yeah, I liked it. But like this, the dog in that, I don't know if it's based on a real dog, but he's like CG. It's pretty wild.
Do they make it look like amazingly real, or they make it look too perfect?
It is very perfect to the point where you can tell it's not a real dog, you know, but it, I don't know. There's a lot of parts in it that where he's almost cartoony and it's funny, you know, it's really funny. It's almost like a Norman Rockwell kind of painting, kind of funny.
Mm-hmm.
And I can see why it works. It doesn't, you know, it didn't like pull me out or whatever. Because when I saw that he wasn't a real dog, I was kind of like, I'm not sure I'm going to like this, but it's pretty good. White Dog, 1982. Somebody said that. I never heard of that one.
White Dog.
White Dog, I've never seen that. I've seen, what about Ghost Dog?
Watchers is a great dog movie. Watchers? Ghost Dog? Oh, yeah, that's that weird.
Ghost Dog. I don't know what you're going to say about it. Let's hear it.
Samurai.
Yeah. That guy was brought into the future. What's his name? Whitaker.
Yeah. Forrest Whitaker, yeah.
He's standing in the future.
Oh, okay, yeah.
That was such a weird one, yeah. I don't know. That's one of those movies I wasn't sure if I liked it or not. So that's one of those movies I don't know if I liked it or not.
Yeah, I was like, he's like, what am I gonna watch?
Hood Samurai. There you go. That's a disgusting rest of the set. French Blackbacker. So it's that.
Got it. Nailed it.
Yeah.
Stinch, what are you doing up so late? Early.
Early late.
Maybe he's drawing with us. Maybe he's doing comics. Keep going, Stinch.
I ain't see him on my show, Stinch.
Don't give up.
Stinch is in the AAA creators community also.
Oh, yes?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Total realism creates the Uncanny Valley effect, like in Tom Hanks' Christmas Train movie. Yeah, I agree. Like, that's one where it's like I like the movie, but then it looks weird, you know? Go ahead.
I was going to say, what about Leia? What did y'all think about young Leia?
Oh, you went right to it, man.
Hell yeah, bro, because that matters to me. You're talking about my heart. Jeff, my
whole
movie.
Oh, cool. Was that a gator coming out of the back there? That's pretty neat. Oh, nice, like dinosaur
action. Yeah, definitely. Very cool. Very cool. Whatever Star Wars that was, I guess it was Rebel.
Yeah.
Whatever, where she comes out.
She's like, yeah. It's like,
oh, yeah. Was it Rogue One or which one?
Yeah, whatever. Rogue One. Yeah, I think that's it.
Oh. Well, did they have her young in the last thing also? Because I haven't seen Rogue One, but I saw her. Or maybe they just had her in it. And
she was already old, but she had died in real life towards the end of doing that. So.
But no, they pop her up young at one point too.
I didn't see the last one. I saw Rogue One though, which was like a prequel to Star Wars New Hope.
Yeah, with the Death Star plans.
Yeah.
I think they should have just got rid of her myself. She died, you know. They still had Luke. Why didn't they just keep Luke in it? Rewrite.
They should have just cheeseballed it out, dude. They should have shoved it to like an escape pod. And they're like, no, where are you going? Just show clean the back of the head and then show it just shoot off and you get shot down. Just make it cheesy as fuck. They pissed all over it. They might as well have made it that bad.
Yeah.
Oh, for the love of God.
But I was going to say, as far as the White Fang movie, I mean, it was, you know, like the animation in White Fang compared to like the Tom Hanks Christmas movie. I mean, there's just no comparison, you know. It's so much better. And then I was also going to say that, like, because I'm with you, like most of those video movies where it's too real, I don't like it. But then, like, I remember 10-10. It was kind of like this weird stylized realism. And that looked good. I mean, that's a really good movie.
Yeah, I like 10-10. I was hoping they keep doing it. But
yeah.
No, I think
that kind of was supposed to be done more.
When they do like this painterly looking thing with it, I think it looks cool. Like when they do like the Sin City thing, that looks cool. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I think they could do it. I think they could, like we talked about before, and they even had, I swear there was like some sort of test footage at one point in time for Zeta Fire and Ice that Robert Rodriguez was going to do or whatever.
Yeah.
And that thing was like, I don't know. I was excited about that.
But wasn't that going to be actors and stuff? I mean, it wasn't going to be all CG, was it?
Oh, I thought it was going to be CG, like when we call painterly. I don't know where I got that. I got an idea, but that's what I did.
Like Beowulf was a CG, but
yeah, like that, yeah.
Yeah. I didn't like the animation in that though. That's like one that
I didn't really like it. It kind of took me out of it.
Yeah.
But I think they were still kind of playing with it then a little bit more. And nowadays, they've got it, that stuff online. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
No excuses, Gabe. They messed up.
They messed up, huh? They just, the technology's there now. They tried too early.
No, I do agree, though. Like,
yeah.
It seems like now, you know, I mean, because that was still probably.
Yeah, that was still in the infancy.
Yeah. So. Like 15 years ago, probably.
They just crap that shit out now.
And I wasn't even born yet. Not so much.
Like 5 years ago. Just kidding. We all know she's 12.
She was barely popping out of the snake egg at that point.
I'm young too, Jeff.
Young at heart.
We ain't old over there, Frank. I ain't old. How dare you?
Pixel says, crazy how the practical effects hold up still. And I agree. Yeah. I think a lot of the practical effect movies do actually hold up. Even when they look dated, they still look good.
Even Ghostbusters use practical effects. Some of it still holds up.
Yeah. Something eerie about practical effects. I can't remember what it was we watched with the kids. Something.
Beastmaster? And
yeah, it was. It was Beastmaster. We watched a little bit of Beastmaster with the kids. And like some of the practical effects are freaking my kids up there. There was a witch that was like had a mask on. And my kids did not like it. They're like, what the hell is going on here? I was like, that's good. I don't know, sometimes like a mat, you know, when they do it right, it just has like this effect of dead skin, and it's just like, ooh, it's spooky.
Yeah. No, I agree. I think, I mean, there's definitely bad, especially, you know, practical effects also, but I don't know.
Called Tromaville.
Right.
Yeah.
But, I mean, like, I don't know, like, to me, like, the Yoda is a good example. Yoda in, like, the old Star Wars compared, like, you know, remaking him into, like, the CG Yoda. I don't know, you know, it's just, because there's good parts in that, too, though. I don't know.
How does this look, guys? I think the condom might be too dark.
The what? It's too dark?
The gauntlet?
The gauntlet.
I think it might be too dark.
Yeah, that or like maybe put like a halo around the rest. Does that make sense?
Yeah, that's what I was trying to do, but yeah, I'll do that.
Yeah, because it kind of does get lost a little once it goes over where the black is. But yeah. Looks pretty good. I could tell what was going on.
That's it. I quit.
Show the streams over. Greg got pee anyway.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Oh, this is getting kind of late. Maybe I should.
Keith Harper's got it. White line it out. He's perfectly right. Get you some white out or a gel pen and kind of highlight a little white liner on it. You ain't got that. Use acrylic paint.
Yeah, he actually, Frank said Blade Runner still looks fantastic. I agree. That's a great example. I thought of that, but then I thought, well, there's not that many, I don't know, monsters and stuff in that one. But then he's also talking about Alien, which is another one.
Yeah, well, those are great. Yeah, dude, I don't know.
X Hangout, yeah. Predator is like another one. And even like, you know, some of the real ones like the Harryhausen stuff, even though they look kind of funny and stuff, I still dig them, you know?
Yeah, like Clash of the Titans, I still like it.
Yeah. Well, I was fact. Oh, yeah. The Harryhausen stuff, yeah. But like,
fun.
Yeah.
The original,
the Sinbad, yeah. Like Sinbad and Jason the Argonauts, like those, those are the ones I really like, you know. There's corny parts of Clash of the Titans that, like, I want to just throw that owl in the ocean.
What?
There
you
go. Oh, yeah.
But
that little owl's your friend, Jeff. You're so mean. Somebody just go ahead and get a fucking PETA call on Jeff, please, because obviously he hates animals.
That thing's not even an animal. It's just like a clock.
The embodiment of an animal, Jeff.
The clockwork owl?
Yeah.
He can't stand it.
I thought it was pretty cool. But I was a kid when I saw it.
Yeah, I was a kid. Yeah. I was all like, oh, look, you got it. It's so cute. Nope.
Man. Oh, yeah. When I saw it as a kid.
Dude,
yeah, it was like flawless back then. But then, yeah, like nowadays when I watch it, I'm like, that thing bugs me.
When they stab that severed head of that devil creature or whatever they did with the blood, scorpions or whatever, as a kid, that tripped me out. Man, I was like, wow.
Yeah, that movie did freak me out because I saw it at night. So I was like, but yeah, this is right.
I still that. Blown away by that, like, whoa.
Yeah.
Oh, it was cool, though. In the swamps.
And actually, you know, when you think about it, like, the best example of that, like, the practical effects holding up is, like, Star Wars.
Oh, yeah.
You know, that's still really good.
I just look.
Oh, yeah, it looks pretty good.
What about my favorite? You gotta throw it out there, Big Trouble in Little China.
Oh yeah. That's
I'm still good. Still enjoyable. Nothing wrong with that movie.
Yeah.
It's like I wish they'd have made more than one. Don't do it now.
No.
For the love of God, don't do it now.
Yeah, to me like I wish they would have done a series.
Big Trouble in Big China.
Yeah. They've done a series of that. back then, that would have been great. But yeah, I agree. Like, they'll do it now and they'll fucking completely just make it super lame.
Who is that? Kurt Russell?
I'm surprised Disney's not trying to buy it, like, as we speak. We must wreck it.
Old Jack Burton always says.
Yeah. Or if they do it now, then have Kurt Russell old in it.
Try to have him come back and still just be a badass. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's a character you could play old.
Yeah. Or that would make him like a wash up. That might even be better, dude. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Make him where he's just not a badass anymore, and he's kind of having to come to terms with it. Write this shit down, people. We're making a movie.
No.
And they did Bill and Ted's. If they're going to do it, let's make it right.
Oh, yeah. See, that's one that I haven't seen it. I don't know if it's out yet or whatever, but I just sitting there, like, looking at it, I really wince at, like, what that's going to be. That Bill and Ted. What do you think? You guys think that looks good?
My family watched it. It's all right.
Or, so it is actually out already then?
Well, you can get it. Yeah, well, they basically released it straight to on demand because of the theater situation.
Mm.
Why, what's going on?
Yeah, what's up with the rentals? Well,
it's just worried everybody's talking about, you know.
I thought COVID was over. They voted Trump out, didn't they?
Yeah. Like I say all the time, man, it's not me, people. It's all
the problems are over.
With the hard times, we're done.
I can't help it. Like, I get this weird feeling, and what I think it is it's like Jib's like invades my mind, and then I say what Jib would have said. So it's not always my fault.
Powers of manipulation and influence.
That's right. He's like a spangle.
If I could work on my wife and people to buy my fucking comic book, we'd be getting somewhere.
Then Stinchwaller or whatever his name is, says, taken to Detroit. And then Pixel Trader says it was a worthy sequel. Wonder what he's talking about. Oh, he's talking about the Bill and Ted's thing.
Yeah.
Oh, Face of Music? I haven't seen it, but here it's good.
I guess I shouldn't rag on it.
Oh, let me go see it.
I haven't seen it yet either. I saw the old one.
Yes, me and Anna. We haven't seen it. We're going to shoot our mouths off about it.
Okay. I saw the first two recently on YouTube. They're for free.
Oh, really? Actually, I mean, that is funny. Like, the second one with, like, where they're playing, like, all those games with, like, death, like Battleship.
Yeah.
That's funny shit right there.
I mean, I don't know. It's like they were great. They were good. They were completely ridiculous. You know, it's like they wouldn't even dare touch a movie like that nowadays if it wasn't already made and known to be a success.
Oh, yeah.
That thing would roll across somebody's desk and they'd be like, hell no, just send that shit straight to the trash.
Yeah. Yeah, all we're doing now is just making sequels anyway. So, unless it was made 30 years ago, they don't even want to look at it.
Well, I mean, I feel like that about a lot of stuff right now. There is some stuff I want to see. I've heard some good stuff about this movie. I think it's called Mandy. With, what's his name? Damn it. Nicolas Cage. It's got Glenn Danzig in it. Something. I only watch movies with Glenn Danzig in it, people. Just ordered it. I got it through Wish.
Well, what is it, this thing with Nicolas Cage? I mean, I haven't seen him forever either. So is it like a remake of something, or is it like a new movie, or what?
Hold on. What movie? I don't know what the hell's talking about, Nicolas Cage, dude. God damn it.
I thought you said the movie Mandy.
Mandy, that's it. Yeah, some movie made. It's some recent movie. There you go. Yes. Thank you for putting me back on track. Brain fart. Yeah, Mandy. It's like this weird horror movie. First person that mentioned it to me was Keith Harper. But it looks cool, man. It looks crazy. Looks like a wild ride, yeah. So I'm really interested in it. It looks kind of artsy.
Isn't that a Barry Manilow song?
Yeah.
Mandy, you're a fine girl. So you came and you saw you.
There you go. You know all the words. Come on, sing it.
No, dude, I'm gonna be horrible. Right? You don't want this. You don't want this.
We should have a Barry Manilow one night.
I'm up for it. I love Barry Manilow.
I don't even know. What's the do Donkey Shane? Donkey Shane.
Yeah. I don't even know.
That'd
be fun.
That's Wayne Newman, right?
Wayne
Newton.
Yeah. He says, Stitch Walker says, highly recommend Miami Beyond the Black Rainbow.
And Beyond the Black Rainbow. I'm going to write that down. That sounds good. I want to see some good movies. Very good.
Color Theory, did I miss that?
Yeah.
Oh, Anna's still here?
Yeah, still here in the drawing zone.
Yeah.
You go, girl.
Oh, you have to end that with a snap, Frank.
Okay.
There you go. There it is. Oh, damn. That's it. Now the show's demonetized. Thank you, Frank. bringing them down one show at a time.
Yeah. They're all demonetized. I can't really keep one of these monetized. It's crazy.
Good. That's when you know they're good, man. That's when you know they're good. Yeah, I want helps to get like I need to get a fucking sponsorship like by Shiner Block or something. And I just need free beer. I don't need much. I'll take a t-shirt and free beer.
Yeah.
It's like I don't need pencils. Y'all can have it get your COVID sponsorships. I just need a beer sponsorship. You hear me, Shinerbach?
I need a C4 sponsorship.
There you go.
Get it back.
With a special Chuck Norris recommendation.
I know, man. He should cut that video for free and give you a sponsorship.
We could just cut it, you know, get a picture of him and cut the mouth movements in.
Yeah, we can do it ourselves. We'll deep fake that shit. It's not really deep fake. It'll be like a shallow flesh wound. How about an abrasion? It'll be an abrasion.
Mandy is badass, says Keith Harper. Yeah, maybe I'll have to punt this up and see what it is.
Well, it's a good song.
Yeah. Yeah. You'd have a... I forgot. Who sings Mandy? Well, you talk about
Barry Manilow. Barry Manilow.
Slash Neil Diamond. Slash Billy. Who's the other guy? Sings the same.
Billy Joel.
Billy Joel. Yeah. Knight.
What?
And Joe can sing all the songs because I don't do karaoke.
Yeah, I don't do karaoke. Yeah, chump.
This page is almost done.
Nice.
We're knocking them out. Very cool.
Well, anyway, so it is like 12:30. Do you think we ought to wrap her up? Or you guys want to keep going like all night? We're doing an 8-hour cast? Or?
Oh, yeah, Jeff wants to do the insomnia cast.
A what cast?
The insomnia cast.
Oh, the insomnia cast, yeah. Could do that.
Mm-mm. I gotta pee.
Yeah, Keith says I'm talking about the Nick Cage movie. Oh, cool.
It looks slightly deranged.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Good. You're just knocking them out.
All right, bam.
Yeah. All right, well, cool. So this has been the ArtCast with my guest, the Turaco Cast on the ArtCast.
All right, the invasion of the Turaco Cast.
That's right. We hit the big time.
Yeah, thanks for coming on. Go subscribe to Anna's channel. Go subscribe to the Turaco Cast channel, which I'll find some links and put them in the description under the video after this video. And also subscribe to Frank Salazar. So I'll go hunt up all those links. Subscribe to Jibrin, who is, you know, like the fourth stepchild of this podcast. We know we're talking about.
I got a Twitch comment real quick. We got a Twitch comment that says, I think the name is Chandi.
Yeah.
It says beauty fart. Okay, go ahead.
Oh, those are coming from Twitch. I didn't realize that. Cool. All right, yeah, so we got a viewer on Twitch now. Cool.
All right, and do part to all y'all too on Twitch.
Does those comments like go on to my YouTube channel, or are they just
They're just popping in. They're just popping into the StreamYard.
Into the StreamYard, but that's kind of nice that I can see it without actually having to go over there. Yeah. All right.
Very cool.
See you guys. Have fun.
All right.
That's it.
See ya.